Well, welcome to the first of our Lenten prayer services midweek. I hope that you're well wherever you are watching this from. And I hope that as we walk through this time together, that you do more than just watch this, but that you enter into prayer, that Lent can become a season of expectancy and hope and repentance. And all of that through an increase of prayer, an increase in our conversation with the God who is present to us. And so, to remind us that God is present with us, I'm going to light a candle as a physical reminder we are not alone, that we worship a God who dwells with his people. You may be following along with either online or printed a prayer guide. We originally created these for there to be a lot of responsive readings and responsive prayers. If you need to listen and enter into prayer that way, that's fine. But if you would like to be responding in the prayers, you can read along with everything, or you can simply read the bolded parts as a way of participating in this prayer. So find yourself in a comfortable position. Take a deep breath. One other thing is, this is the first Wednesday of Lent. This is also Ash Wednesday, and so we've hopefully provided you with some temporary tattoos in the shape of a cross. We wish that we could be administering these ashes in person as we have done in the past, but we just can't do that this year. So I've got mine on my hand, and with that, let's pray together. Frail mortals are filled with the rich plenty of your house, and you give them to drink from the stream of your delights. For with you is the fountain of life. Psalm 31:1. Almighty God, you give the water of eternal life through Jesus Christ, your Son. May we always thirst for you, the spring of life and the source of goodness, through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.
What wondrous love is this, O my soul, O my soul? What wondrous love is this, O my soul? What wondrous love is this that caused the Lord of bliss to bear the dreadful curse for my soul, to bear the dreadful curse for my soul. To God and to the Lamb I will sing, great I am. While millions join the theme, I will sing, I will sing. While millions join the theme, I will sing.
Psalm 27. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When evildoers assail me to devour my flesh, my adversaries and foes, they shall stumble and fall. Though an army encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war rise up against me, yet I will be confident. One thing I ask of the Lord, that I will seek after, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For he will hide me in his shelter in the day of trouble. He will conceal me under the cover of his tent. He will set me high on a rock. Now my head is lifted up above my enemies all around me, and I will offer in his tent sacrifices with shouts of joy. I will sing and make melody to the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry aloud. Be gracious to me and answer me. Come, my heart says, seek his face. Your face, Lord, do I seek. Do not hide your face from me. Do not turn your servant away in anger. You who have been my help, do not cast me off. Do not forsake me, O God of my salvation. If my father and my mother forsake me, the Lord will take me up. Teach me your way, O Lord, and lead me on a level path because of my enemies. Do not give me up to the will of my adversaries, for false witnesses have risen against me, and they are breathing out violence. I believe that I shall see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and let your heart take courage. Wait for the Lord. Isaiah 55, verses 1 through 13. We're going to read this passage twice with some space for silent, prayerful reflection in the middle. Come, all you who are thirsty, come to the waters. And you who have no money, come buy and eat. Come buy wine and milk without money and without cost. Why spend money on what is not bread, and your labor on what does not satisfy? Listen, listen to me and eat what is good, and you will delight in the richest of fare. Give ear and come to me. Listen, that you may live. I will make an everlasting covenant with you, my faithful love promised to David. See, I have made him a witness to the peoples, a ruler and a commander of the peoples. Surely you will summon nations you know not. Nations you do not know will come running to you because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, for he has endowed you with splendor. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call on him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake their ways and the unrighteous their thoughts. Let them turn to the Lord, and he will have mercy on them, and to our God, for he will freely pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, declares the Lord. As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. As the rain and snow come down from heaven and do not return to it without watering the earth and making it bud and flourish, so that it yields seed for the sower and bread for the eater, so is my word that goes out from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but will accomplish what I desire and achieve the purpose for which I sent it. You will go out in joy and be led forth in peace. The mountains and hills will burst into song before you, and all the trees of the field will clap their hands. Instead of the thornbush will grow the juniper, and instead of briars, the myrtle will grow. This will be for the Lord's renown, for an everlasting sign that will endure forever. Come, all you who are thirsty. Come to the waters. And you who have no money, come, buy and eat. Come buy wine and milk without money and without cost. Why spend money on what is not bread, and your labor on what does not satisfy? Listen, listen to me and eat what is good, and you will delight in the richest of fare. Give ear and come to me. Listen that you may live. I will make an everlasting covenant with you, my faithful love promised to David. See, I have made him a witness to the peoples, a ruler and commander of the peoples. Surely you will summon nations you know not, and nations you do not know will come running to you because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel. For he has endowed you with splendor. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call on him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake their ways and the unrighteous their thoughts. Let them turn to the Lord, and he will have mercy on them. And to our God, for he will freely pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, declares the Lord. As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. As the rain and the snow come down from heaven and do not return to it without watering the earth and making it bud and flourish, so that it yields seed for the sower and bread for the eater, so is my word that goes out from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but will accomplish what I desire and achieve the purpose for which I sent it. You will go out in joy and be led forth in peace. The mountains and hills will burst into song before you, and all of the trees of the field will clap their hands. Instead of the thorn bush will grow the juniper, and instead of briars, the myrtle will grow. This will be for the Lord's renown, for an everlasting sign that will endure forever. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Have mercy on me.
holy and merciful God, we confess to you and to one another and to the whole communion of saints in heaven and on earth that we have sinned by our own fault in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole mind, our whole heart and mind and strength. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We have not forgiven others as we have been forgiven. Have mercy on us, O God. O Christ, out of your fullness, we have all received grace upon grace. You are our eternal hope. You are patient and full of mercy. You are generous to all who call upon you. Save us, O Lord. O Christ, fountain of life and holiness, you have taken away our sins. On the cross, you were wounded for our transgressions and were bruised for our iniquities. Save us, Lord. O Christ, obedient unto death, source of all comfort, our life and our resurrection, our peace and reconciliation. Save us, Lord. O Christ, Savior of all who trust you, hope of all who die for you, and joy of all the saints. Save us, Lord. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us peace. Amen.
In the morning when I rise, in the morning when I rise, in the morning when I rise, give me Jesus, give me Jesus, give me Jesus. You can have all this world, but give me Jesus. When I am alone, when I am alone, when I am alone, give me Jesus, give me Jesus, give me Jesus. You can have all this world, give me
to die. Oh, when I come to die, when I come to die, give me Jesus, give me Jesus, give me Jesus. In the morning when I rise,
in the morning when I rise. In the morning when I rise, give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Keep hold of what is good and avoid all forms of evil. May God Himself, the God of peace, make you holy through and through and keep you sound in spirit, soul, and body, free of any fault when our Lord Jesus Christ comes. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain in you. Amen. Go in peace.